Please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get further notifications. And all these errors have to be taken care of. That is in drawing namespace, drawing 2D. Basically, I have a ready-made function. This I have copied from internet. This function is going to get as input one image, and whatever is the converted thumbnail in JPG format, that I'm going to get in this output. So input is the stream, output is also a stream. Input stream is the blob, which is the original image. Output stream is the blob, which I'm going to save it as the thumbnail. So you can probably read the code later. Pretty standard bitmap class has been used with the specified width and height, which is computed for thumbnail and so on. Thumbnail, we are fixing it as 80 pixel. Thumbnail size is 80 pixel. You can change this in case you want smaller. So this convert image to thumbnail is being called here. So output blob, which is this dot open right, I get the output stream of that blob, and into that output stream, I'm getting the thumbnail image, mentioning that as JPG. So can I say that this is going to be the code which will update the blob with a new image, the thumbnail image? But what is also important is this, I have to save it in the database. So I have my demo context. Blob information gave me the ID. I'm finding an employee with that ID. If the employee is not there with that ID, throwing an exception. But if the employee is there, updating the URI of the blob, the new image URI, we are storing it in the thumbnail and saving it to the database. Pretty simple and straightforward code. So this code, I've used entity framework. You may not want to use entity framework. You may want to write the raw ADO.NET code. That's your choice. Like in the handout, I've given that also, commented code. You create a connection object from the environment.get environmental variables. My demo context, get the connection string. And once you have the connection string, write the simple ADO.NET code for update statement. That's your choice, how you do it. I've used entity framework for doing that, a more modern approach. So now we need to test it. So for testing, you have to ensure that in the settings.json, you have given proper connection string. You have given proper storage account references, all set. So what I'll do now is, go to solution, go to properties, and here I'll make current selection. So whatever project is selected, that will execute. So first I'll execute the function. Control F5. Console window will open. The function will execute. And actually, one message is already there in the queue. That message which should be automatically picked up by this particular function. And a thumbnail should be created and uploaded. Let's see if that is happening. Oh, some error. Okay. By default, function is not using the latest version of framework. We'll have to change that. My DLL is using 6.2. Hence, function should also use 6.2. Control F5 for execution. Azure function logo. Registered. And you see function has automatically started. Why this function got executed? New queue message detected on thumbnail request. And the function got executed also successfully. So because it got executed successfully, if I come and refresh this page, I should have a thumbnail for the last one. Let's check. Perfect. We got the thumbnail image. And you see it is a JPG file with underscore thumbnail.jpg appended to it. So this is the main file which was uploaded. And in background, this thumbnail was computed by Azure function. Moreover, I can just add a new function now. Let's say EMP4. Another image I upload. And you'll notice immediately it has not come because the function has to execute. The function executed. Now you come and refresh and we should have the thumbnail also. Yeah, now it is completed. Took little time. Now, perfect. But right now, my web application is posted locally. Azure function is also hosted locally. I want to move everything into Azure so that from Azure itself, all this can execute. I don't want anything to execute from my local machine. That is the requirement. And that will be my final steps. So first, I'm going to publish this web application as an Azure App Service web app. So I go to publish option and I would like to create an app service, a new app service I would like to create. From studio only, I'm doing everything. Instead of going through portal and creating an app service web app, from studio itself, I'm trying to create a app service web app. It's already there. So add DSS. Choose your subscription. Choose your resource group. Oh, it's not showing webinar resource group which I created. Yeah, it's here. Webinar RG. Hosting plan default is okay. SQL database already created. Storage account already created. So these two we don't have to do it now. Otherwise, these two also we can create from here itself. Click on create. You can see here deploying. This has to finish. So actually in portal, the app is getting created. You can go to the portal, go to app service, and you'll notice here, after a while, we should have the new web app getting created. Don't worry about this. DSS EMP web app. And of course, into that DSS EMP web app, I should publish my application. And that will be done by clicking on this publish button. The whole application will get published. at the same time as this is publishing, I have to also take care of publishing the function into Azure. So right click here, I don't think it will allow. Yeah, it's disabled. We'll have to wait for this publishing to complete. All the files are being uploaded. Of course, in the meantime, the local instance, we can terminate because we want this also to run in Azure only now. So press Ctrl C and terminate the local instance of the Azure function. I didn't have to take care of the connection string because for local development also, I mentioned the connection string of the Azure database only. Otherwise, we have to take care of connection string. Now, go to the function. And publish the function. Azure function app. We want to create a new function app. Thumbnail function app. The resource group. Now, we can either use an existing hosting plan, which we used earlier, or we can create a new plan. Preferably use the existing hosting plan only. That will save your cost. But at the same time, you have to ensure that always on will be enabled on this particular plan. How? I'll show you that. Automatically, it will be done anyhow, but still we can as well do it. Click on create. So this is going to create in portal an Azure function. A function app. Right now, not there. We'll have to wait for this to complete. You can see the progress here. Yeah, it's done. Now go to portal, refresh. We have DSS thumbnail function. But there are no functions right now. We have to publish a function into it. Right now, there is no function. But even before I publish a function, over here, I have to take care of the connection string. So go to platform features and in application settings, we have to take care of the connection string. So right now there is no connection string. So add a connection string. The name of the connection string, you should take it from here. Something very important, remember, you can always conflict and say, you have already mentioned connection string here. Why do you need to mention again in Azure? We did not do that actually in web app, but why we have to mention connection string explicitly in Azure for a function? Remember, this is only a local file. This is only for local execution. This is not for Azure. So none of these settings are going to reflect in Azure. Very important. So this name, my demo context, under which we have got connection string and provider. So this my demo context is what we have to provide here. And of course, the value also we will copy from here. And paste it. Ensure that type is SQL Azure. And that SQL Azure is what actually is the value of provider. System.data.sqlclient. That will be taken care of. So this is very important. And of course, Azure Web Jobs storage and dashboard is already taken care. You don't have to do this. But connection string, you'll have to explicitly mention it. These things got copied. Now, save it. Let's publish. Right click on the function, publish. Profile was already created earlier. Publish. And you'll have to notice that publishing has completed over here. publishing started and publishing completed. That's what we should get here. And once it is completed, you'll notice that the web application is already deployed. DSS EMP web apps dot Azure websites dot net. We should go to employees. And here, to see what is the status of the function, you can actually go to the function. Not published yet. Yeah, now it is completed. So refresh it. Expand function one. You have to scroll a bit and you get your logs. You can read the logs. So here I add a new record now. And some file we have to mention. JPJ, PNG. Submit. So again, like before, this is now executed on Azure. We don't get this, but you'll notice here, we should have after some time a message which says that the function started. And once that function started and completed, you'll notice here on refresh, we should have the thumbnail computed. Right now, not there. We'll see the storage account also side by side. Queue storage. Thumbnail request. Oh, it's not picking up. The reason it's not picking up the message is, I'll have to check. We have to check if the storage application settings. Demo storage correct only. It should pick up. We can wait. Because this message should go away. Why the function is not triggering. Let me trigger it manually. Actually, this should not be the requirement. Something went wrong also. Yeah, the storage name is wrong. Let me correct this name. So what I'll do is I'll first go to my storage. The default storage name which is given is not correct. So I'll go to my storage, get the connection string. So I'll copy this, and this I should use it in the function. Same thing here. And save this. Now let's try once again. We should actually speaking. I'm not very sure, but ideally, yes. You can stop. It's not done. It's still saving. I don't know why it's taking time. You can stop and start. Ideally, I'm not very sure whether it is mandatory or not, but it's recommended because we have changed the settings. And even without this, it should work. With the old record is already there, that should be picked up and updated. We should have a thumbnail created for this. Perfect. See, all of them have thumbnail. The previous one was also processed and the current is also processed, and it's all on Azure. Actually speaking, you can also type this URL immediately right now and test it. Nothing from my local machine is being used. You can type the web application is hosted, the Azure function is hosted, web application gives the response immediately. And then the Azure function executes in background from the main image. It creates the thumbnail image, updates it in the database. Of course, little bit of extra code can be written. An AJAX call can be made to refresh this particular page so that we can get the latest content here. That code can be written extra in case it is needed. Of course, right now these are text format I'm showing. That can be replaced with image tag. And you can give an SRC with the URL of this particular image also. That also you can do it. So there is a complete walkthrough in the handout, step by step I have given to you people. You can just follow these steps as it is, and everything is there, and we produce the same solution. What is important here to understand is how we are exploiting different services of Azure in modern application development. If I was not using Azure for all these things, where will I store my images? How will I ensure that the background task is getting executed? All this will not be as simple as they are now. Of course, we have solutions in the past also. We might probably store all the images in the file system. We might have a Windows service which is executing in background, which is responsible for converting the images. But how will that Windows service get triggered? So for that, we will have to write some extra code for invoking the Windows service programmatically, and so on and on. So instead of doing all these things, Azure has given a ready-made infrastructure. In short, modern programming is going to become much more simpler because of ready-made services which are provided by Azure.